This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. Let's jump into the next topic.
So the last piece that we're going to talk about here is the ingress. And this is a way to route external traffic on HTTP and HTTPS only. So ingress is HTTP and HTTPS. Node port, you can route other types of traffic to that node port and it will work. But ingress is specifically for web traffic, essentially. And that allows you to map it from outside the cluster to a services within inside the cluster. The traffic routing is controlled by rules defined on the ingress resource. So we'll see that in a minute. But basically, it's going to be looking for something like a DNS name and then a path that someone would type into their web browser. And it's going to recognize that, be able to read those headers from that web request and pass it to the appropriate resource inside the cluster. For MinIO, we can use an ingress to expose MinIO server to the outside world on standard ports 80 and 443. So it would be some URL that gets typed into the browser, hits the ingress. The ingress reads that traffic header, sees what path is requested, and then based on certain routing rules, will pass it to the appropriate service and then the underlying pods that are supporting that service. So let's take a look at the demo for this. So the first thing we're going to take a look at in the demo is what ingress classes we have. So you can see that we have one ingress class defined. You can have multiple, but it gets more confusing the more you have. So in this case, we're just going to have one, and it's the ingress nginx sort of default Kubernetes ingress controller that's running here. Note that it says the name is nginx, and that's going to be important when we go to deploy something because we have to refer to that name. So this is defined, and if we do a describe on this resource, we can get some more information about this. Note these labels. These are just some additional definitions that are applied to this, just letting us know what type this is. But the important piece here is that the annotation that this is the default ingress class. So if it's not defined within an ingress definition of which ingress class you want to use, then we'll automatically use this one. I do recommend, however, that within your definitions of what you're deploying for ingresses, you specify the name of the ingress controller that you want to use. Let's take a look at our ingress YAML now. So you can see here that we are defining a number of things in this. The first thing we're going to define is that this is a ingress inside the namespace of MinIO, and that we are defining the ingress class we want to use. So even though Nginx is a default, I recommend again that you define the ingress class that you want to use. So we're calling the Nginx one. We're saying anything that hits minio-external.this domain name, and this is just a demonstration domain name, on the root path. This could be some subpath like slash web or something like that. But in this case, anything that hits that on the root path will get passed to the service called Nginx external service on port 80. Now, again, that service called Nginx external service will be looking for an app that has app Nginx external. So that's the tag that it's looking for. So it's going to attach to pods that have that tag. And it's expecting traffic on port 80 and passing traffic to port 80. And then lastly, we're going to be running three replicas of an Nginx pod. And these are tagged appropriately with the proper app Nginx external so that the service knows how to look for them. And this is listening on port 80. So that's our entire traffic flow. When someone hits this web address, it's going to hit the service. The service is going to say, okay, where are my pods? I'm passing that traffic onto these pods. And now we can see that it hits these pods on port 80. So let's go ahead and apply this. And now we've deployed that. And if we do kget all, we can see that there are now a number of things deployed in here. And there are some new services here running pods here. And you can see that these are the three pods that we defined in that definition. We can also see that there is a new service here that's also up and running to address that. So ingress is going to pass that name from the outside world, look at those headers, pass it to this cluster IP, and then pass it to these pods right here. If we do a kget ingress on the namespace MinIO, we can see that there's a ingress definition here that says that the host that it's expecting is minio-external.dsodemo.org, and it's addressing these internal references on the hosts to then pass traffic to that service and then to those pods. So let's go take a look at that web link now. So if we come to this page and we type in that name, you can see that now it's addressing these pods from outside the cluster using a DNS name and not one of those ephemeral ports like we did on the node port. So now this, again, this is only web traffic, but it is now a friendly username that someone can use to address an internal service inside the Kubernetes cluster from the outside world. The outside world might be within your environment only, or maybe you're passing this to, you know, externally to other customers within your environments. So that's how that ingress works. That completes the Kubernetes overview portion of this. Hopefully you got some good information out of that. Again, this was all intended to be high level and not a deep dive into everything you need to know about Kubernetes, but mostly about how you can relate these core Kubernetes concepts to what you will be deploying with your MinIO configurations, whether it be your MinIO single node running on Kubernetes or your MinIO operator deployment. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Have a good one.